Now, we have also seen in the mouth that when the child brings the lower jaw forward, there is a significant improvement in the profile. Now, this improvement in the profile has to also be corroborated on the study models. And we can see that when he brings the lower jaw forward, say by 8 millimeter, or in this case, probably 7 millimeters, we are able to get class 1 molar relationship. Here it is pertinent to know that what is the relationship of the buccal cusps of the canines and premolars in this area. Now this, what you see on the model, should always be double checked in the patient's mouth. And let us go back to the patient's mouth now. And it is important now for us to see the what is the relationship of the teeth in the first molar area. As you can see, as the child brings the lower jaw forward by 7 millimeters or so, the molars become class 1 and there is a buccal cross bite here. Similarly, on the left side, although the molars are becoming class 1, there is a posterior cross bite in the premolar region. It is also pertinent to see that if the midlines are matching or not matching. And this is very, very critical for recording the bite. Now, if there is an existing midline shift, and this midline shift is due to dental reasons, then we do not make any effort to correct the midline during recording the bite. Like in this case, we can see the midlines are slightly off, not absolutely off. So in this case, we will not make any effort to correct the midlines because we know this midline problem is because of the slight crowding in the lower anterior region. So as we already know that this child is already trained to bring the lower jaw forward, and what he needs to do is he should know that we will put some wax on his lower teeth and he will be asked to bite there. So have you understood? Yes? It's a good idea to place two stickers, one on the chin and one on the nose. When the face height is measured, it's a good idea to ask him to remain relaxed. This can also be done using a caliper. So this is 69 millimeters and this is recorded. It is always a good idea to have two set of models. One is the working model, and these models are prepared from freshly made alginate impressions. And it is important that these models are not old, because these models will be used to construct the appliance. And these are called working models. The study models are also with us, which already have bases on it. And these can be marked to transfer the bite and see that how much changes we have brought in the mouth while recording the bite. The tray setup for the recording the bite is, as you can see here, that it is a good idea to keep everything handy, and the important one being the measuring instruments, the ruler, of course the wax bite, the wax sheet, hot water and cold water. And your spirit lamp should be always away from the patient. And if you are using a spirit lamp, make it sure that you have enough spirit in it. So we normally use wax sheets. There are more than one way of doing the bite recording. You can do it on project bite goes. You can do that on project bite goes as recommended by Clark. Or if you do not have one, you can use a wax sheet. Now this is a modeling wax which is gently warmed. make it like a horseshoe shape. Try to see that it follows the curves of the dental arch of the patient. And if there is any excess, trim that away.